All right, last we left off, we got invited to go to a bar, but I was afraid of, but then the cowgirl, our coworker, was all, come jogging with me. And so I thought, you know what? I didn't want to reject her in the off chance that I didn't get a chance to hang out with Porcupine at the bar. So it's like, you know what? Let's go hang out with her. Let's go for a jog with our coworker, you know, bonding outside of the workplace, you know, kind of thing. Oh, it's gonna stop us. Oh, hello. Oh. Oh no, what's happening? Why is everything off? I'm glad though, cause like, so we have this thing. If anyone's watched Moon Knight, apparently they show this in the show. I've seen Moon Knight. Some systems have items they can use to like more easily talk to each other. We got our setup in the new house just in time for when we get sick, and at least. Oh, so you have a, like a telecom system in your house? I'm trying to remember Moon Knight. I don't, the only time I could think that that would happen is if they, when it was like the mental hospital scenes. Is that what you mean? Like a telecom system? There we go. There you are. No, it's still cutting off! Okay, I want to get some exercise in today. We've seen. Okay, so yeah. Alright, come on, race you to school, sports court. If you insist, great. On your marks, get set. Is that Krakowski? She looks angry. What? Go! Oh, more like a way for system members to, like, speak to each other. I think Moon Knight, they used a mirror. Are you talking about the altars? Because they would use reflections to... Oh! Oh, so do you have altars? Is that what you're saying, Rave? I did not know. If this is true, I did not know. So I didn't understand. Let me reread your sentence again. We have this. Some systems have items. Use more. Is it called like a system? I'm learning. Oh, okay. No, it is all good. If you did insinuate, I probably didn't catch it because... You know, things go over my head a lot of times, so I probably wouldn't have caught it. Yeah, we're two? Cool! But yeah, no, I never would have caught that if you did, because... To be fair, it's not something I think about all the time, and my brain and stuff. But cool, good to know. Good to know. Now I understand. Now your sentence of what you explained before makes more sense to me now. Now I get it. cool. Sorry, my brain. That's fair, I really should say it more clearly. For a while, I was very under the radar about it and lately been more like starting to be more open. Yeah, well, it's all on your own terms. And so that's why I was a little bit hesitant to be like, is that, do you? I don't, but yeah, no, that's totally fair. And yeah. Good for you for feeling more comfy and, you know, doing things on your own terms and stuff. Not, you know, sometimes it's not about nobody's business. It ain't nobody's business. So about the same time, I'm trying to figure out how to this game and the cutoffs. Like, I don't appreciate that it zoomed in and cutting off this. So I'm trying to... Like, it looked like it was just more zoomed in. So I'm hoping it'll fix itself. Cause like, I want to be like, we did read that conversation before last week or last time we played, which was like 2 weeks ago. So I'm hoping that won't be an issue. That's why I wasn't too heartbroken about that combo. Oh. Am I just zigzagging down? Where are we? She's gonna be like, where is this pigeon at? Oh my gosh, have you seen that? Y'all seen that new pigeon game? That, the Battle Royale one, I want it so bad. It looks so funny and so fun. No, come on. Zigzag down. There we go. And the pigeons all look like little they look so phallic. They look so phallic. I made it! Girl, I made it! Took me forever. Oh, she got an outfit change and everything, girl! Wow, what's happening here? What do you think? After a long day, I need to work off a bit of energy. Girl, how do you still have energy after working after work? After working all day? University clinic where I used to work had its own sports field. I discovered this hidden gem last week. I hereby present to you... Oh, nice. So you want me to join in? That's the plan. Today we're playing basketball. It helps. There's me, aka Rave Monster, and my other system member who goes by... Is it pronounced Banshee? I want to make sure I'm pronouncing that right. Goes by Banshee Online. I'm the only one who can... front, so basically I'm always the one people are talking to. Okay. You can think of Ban as like a roommate, basically. Okay. Oh, if it helps. Okay. That's just... Okay, cool. I will admit, I don't know a lot about DID, or system, whatever the proper term is. I don't know a lot about it, so I will... You know, do my best to watch and how wordings and, you know, and but I'm intrigued on learning more because, like, obviously as a lot of mental is it called a mental illness, a lot of things that happen in the brain that people have a lot of misconceptions about, I grew up with those same misconceptions, and I'm, you know, deconstructing and unlearning so much stuff, you know, as being someone who's got, you know, with, you know, my own stuff that's going on. So, like, with everything, I'm just like, I'm unlearning all this crap that we were told and taught. And yeah, so I am the only little new information I know is from Moon Knight, but I'm told by people who have DID that it is one of the more accurate representations because they actually had people with DID on the actual show working on it. The only thing that obviously is not well represented is how quickly he switches between his alters. Because, you know, in comics and movies, you gotta have things happen fast. Pretty much, Banshee? Cool, cool, cool. Well, hi, Banshee. If you say hi. Hi, Banshee. But yeah, this is... I know, because, like, it used to be called something... I forget what the old name used to be called, because it's called DID now. Oh, it used to be called Multiple Personality Disorder, but now they call it DID. Right? Yeah. And, like, in Moon Knight. Yeah, so... I did have a bunch of DID stuff up on my FYP there for a while when Moon Knight was first coming out, because people were like, people who had it were like, oh, this is pretty all right. Some people were like, this isn't all right. I'm like, you know what? Fair. Let me learn some things. And so I've learned some things through that, but I don't know a lot. But yeah. Cool. So I feel free if you have any questions. But yeah, general term, I tend to use this as a system, perfect. But I too am learning new terms, so I get you. And for alters is system members. Okay, cool, cool, cool. System members, that makes sense. And yeah, you did use the term system members earlier too. Cool, cool, cool. Nice. And is Banshee also aware of, like, when you chat and stuff in chat? Or if I were to say, like, hey, Banshee, are you able to communicate that with them? Or they just are aware of it? I'm curious. Interesting. If it's not too invasive, at any point you can just be like, no, stop. And I'll be like, yes. Banshee says hi. Hi, Banshee. But at any point, you can just be like, stop, line drawn, no more. And I'm like, cool. Let's do shoot some hoops. I was always good at school. I got teased a lot for being one of the youngest. But I always got the baskets. Alrighty then, looks like I chose the right guy to play against. Let's see who wins. Ready? Oh no! Am I gonna have to actually give me a minute? I want to take a look around first. Yeah, pass me the boy. Yeah, Ban is basically like a co-pilot. Can't really access the controls, but is always there hanging around. Cool! Do I want to look around? No, but pass me the ball! Just what I wanted to hear. Here we go! Do I have to control anything? Oh, I have to control! No, don't press E! No! No! Dang it! Okay, hold E to charge your throw, release with E, score a basket with the special ball to get 3 points. Okay, I'm just gonna... Ooh! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Let's go! Okay. Woo! Oh, was it yellow? Oh! Oh! Ooh, my reaction time. You're going down, girly. Let's go. Oh. Will our basketballs hit each other if we release at the same time? They do! I knocked her out. I think she was on trajectory to do good, and I knocked her out. She just knocked my ball in. She knocked my ball in. Let's go! I win. She got no points! No points! Oh, there's wee children. Are these wee children? They just... Oh, that bull just walked underneath them. Okay. Oof. Oh, wrong button. You really showed me. I didn't know you were so good. Oh, I think you caught me on a good day. The last time I played basketball was at school. When I start a team in Porcupine, you have to join me. Ha, okay. So, Finley, how do you like it here? Not just work, in general. Oh, yeah, she was trying to ask me something earlier when we got interrupted by the Weasel Man. Weasley Weasel Man. Not just work, in general. Porcupine. It's nice here. I mean, I kind of haven't had much time to get to know the town yet. I haven't even unpacked all my boxes yet. And then I was out of action for a while. It feels a bit like when I first started university. A little lonely. Really? But you're already fitting in so well. How do you mean? Well, somehow you get along with everyone here. And it feels like I don't know anyone yet. I feel a little lonely. Oh no! Okay, but when I played that type of basketball as a kid, I actually did that at some point. Just threw the ball at someone else's. Xavier Menace, yes! It was a game called Bump, right? Like, you each took turns, like, shooting. And then if their ball came too close to you when you were setting up for your next shot, you could bump their ball away using your ball. And then they'd have to go chase it, and you know. And then if you scored on them before they got a score, then they were out. It was kind of like, okay, first person shoots. If they miss, if the second person shoots, then the first person's out. If they get it in before the other person. And so, like, if the second person misses, but then the third person misses, or whatever. Oh, wait, no, we were doing a different thing. Okay. I know there's, like, a lot of games. Like, there's games like Horse, where, like, you try not to spell out the word horse by copying people. But, yeah, I forget what it was called. It was called Bump, I think it was. Oh, children's games. I felt a little lonely. Every time I move... Ooh, sorry. Every time I move town, it gets a little harder somehow. I had a few friends at school. Even at university, I struggled to meet people. In Porcupine, I really only know the people from the hospital. Moving a new place where you know absolutely no one is definitely hard. Good times. I fully forget the name, though. Yeah, there's so many things, like thinking back to grade school, I remember, like, the games that we would play, like... I play Butt Burner with my cat now. I have, like, this bouncy ball that I'll just, like, ricochet off the wall, and he'll, like, swipe at it as it goes by and misses, and sometimes he'll hit it, and then sometimes, you know... I essentially just play Butt Burner with the cat, and I'm just like, yeah, I used to play this all the time, it's great. You really think I'm fitting in well? Totally. Funny, I feel the same way as you, actually. Really? That's a surprise. I haven't had much free time so far. And when I do, I never have the energy to do anything. It's tough to get to know anyone. But I've made up my mind not to get bogged down in work. I want to make sure I always save some energy for trying out new things. Meeting new people. Maybe even making some friends. I'm sure we'll both find friends here. And whenever you want to try something new, you can always let me know. I will, but that's enough for today, I think. I'm starving. I need to make something to eat. Besides, some of us have early shift tomorrow. Oh yeah, we have our first night shift! It's your first night shift, right? Right, I gotta know. Yeah, I hope it goes alright. I'm sure it will. I believe in you. Oh, thank you. But I've gotta go now. See you tomorrow night. Bye! Is it gonna make me run home? Yeah, it's kind of making me run home. Not all the way, but... Oh, shoot. Pump! I just got the achievement! Pump up the jams! Pump it up! Pump up the jam! Pump it up! Ba 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 ba! My apartment's a mess! Actually, it's not that bad, is it? I mean, it's only going to get messy again anyway. That's how I feel. And then I'll just have to tidy it again. That's how I feel. It's like, why put in the effort to tidy things up? Like, there's a difference between clean and tidy, okay? Wash that- make sure y'all washing that toilet at a regular intervals, because, you know, that get nasty. But, like, Sorry, like making my bed every day, I don't make my bed. I just don't. Like, I'll change the sheets as they need to get changed, you know? But I don't make my bed every day. Who's got the time? You know, like... But it's at the same time, though, I like the cleanliness look and the openness and that. Because yesterday, I decided to do, like, a full-on, like, moving my brooms into the closet and then, like, swept my floors properly, beforehand and everything in it. And move things around to sweep under things I haven't swept under in a while. And then just looking at that open space, I'm like, oh, that's so nice. It looks so nice. I know it's going to get covered in... Literally, not even an hour later, I'm walking down... Like, I'm walking from my room to the kitchen, and I see a tumbleweed of cat hair. And I'm like, I moved everything. I just swept. Where did this ball of fur come from? I can't have nice things! Tobias! Uh-huh. Maybe I should just maintain a consistent level of chaos at all times. You know what? Sometimes that's what that's what you can control. It's just a level of chaos. You know, meh. I should put my laundry away at least. Yeah. Otherwise, I'll end up lying. It'll light up around all week. I hope my lazy future self appreciates this. Yeah, let's pick up the clothing. You know, sometimes it's just the small things. Feel free to help out. After all, you live here too. That reminds me, actually, you're behind on rent. Ha ha ha. Oh, hello. Finlu! Hey! Pina, is that you? Bingo! What's up? How's stuff? What's the goss? You still in bed after the accident? Yeah, no, I'm back on my feet now. That was so Canadian. I love the image of it being a tumbleweed of cat hair. It was! A little Western music. It literally was. I walk and then a little wind goes by and then there's just cat hair tumbling and I'm like, stop it! I even played basketball with a colleague yesterday. You play basketball? I wish I'd seen that. Anyway. Are you free right now, by any chance? Yeah, I'm still at home. I'm on my first night shift tonight. Ooh, exciting! Are you nervous? Nope, not yet. I'm sure that'll change later. Hehe. Sounds like a little distraction would do you good. You think you could swing by my store? I could use your help. Oh, Pina is, the person who gave us the flower, right? I wanted to check on the high street anyway. Sure, I'll stop by. Perfecto! Thanks so much! See you soon! Checking my phone. Oh yeah, Pina. I met Pina on my way to work. Very nice. Yeah, flower shop. Mia! Oh, not a porcupine. The porcupine's a janitor. Carlo is the one that invited us. He invited me to go, so I could have went to the bar. I could have went to the bar with Carl. That's fine. We had a nice chat with Mia. Well, hey there. Don't I normally see you walking the other way this time of day? Night shift. Ah, St. Ursula's? That's right. I'm a doctor there. Oh yeah, I've seen you heading that way in the mornings. Got me thinking, actually. I wanted to be a doctor once. Then I changed my mind. Too stressful, I figured. Yeah, being a doctor is so stressful. Always good to know a doctor, though. That's true. And you now know a homeless guy. Who knows when, if that'll come in handy, eh? Say, how are you doing health-wise? Do you need anything? I'm sorry I have to go. You know, how are you doing health-wise? Oh, you know, good days and bad. My legs give me trouble from time to time. But it's no big deal. I can't complain. Not really my style, heh. Are you sure? Positive. Okay, but if you want me to look at anything, don't hesitate to ask, alright? Yes, sir. And same goes for you, eh? Okay. Did we learn some notes? Yeah! Oh, Elfio! What's happening? What's happening? Elfio. This morning, Elfio is sitting in front of my door. He doesn't seem to have a place to stay. Susie is so funny. Oh yeah, Gianio? Giulio. Theobald is a freaking rooster, man! I love him. Okay, we're going to the high street. Don't know where that is. I'm a pigeon, watch me run! Am I heading the right way? Who knows? Okay, wrong way. I remember coming this way before, but, you know, I don't remember anything. I remember this. Hey, your chair was empty last time I was here. What's up, bud? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Talk to me. Talk to me. Hello, caught anything today? The goal is not to catch things, young Finley. How do you know my name? Nothing that would require a hook, at least. So, what are you fishing for, then? The cool air by the river. The murmur and gurgle of the waves. The depths of the stream of consciousness. Moments like this one, that is what I fish for. Wow. I think I might have just caught one as well. Or is it your moment? This one is yours, Finley. You've earned it. Aw, that's so sweet! Thanks. That's so sweet. I love you. I have no idea who you are. Are you in my journal now? Are you on my notes pad? No! You're nameless! Nameless stranger that knows my name! Maybe he's a wise boar that just knows. Knows all. He was a boar, right? I don't know. He looked like he had a snout. Okay. So, he said we're checking out High Street, but if y'all remember, there is a path to go up and then a path to go down. And so far, we've taken the up path because the bottom path has been blocked for some reason or another. But you would think that the low wouldn't be the high road, but I'm thinking this is the high road. You know what I mean? You would think that this would be the low road. Ice cream! I haven't had a single ice cream this summer. I knew I was forgetting something. Yeah. I've been bouncing around the idea of making myself a seasonal list. So things I want to do every season. So like for autumn, this autumn, like carve a pumpkin, which I did do. Watch certain movies, do a couple things here and there, you know. And so for winter, I have a list too, where it's like go skating at least once. Build a snowman. Yes, in my 30, being 30, I still want to build a snowman one, you know, because it's fun. You know, just things like that. Just, and so seasonally, and during the summer, I didn't do half the things I wanted to do. During the summer, I wanted to go to this beach at least once. Did not do that. Go have ice cream. We definitely did that. We got some good old ice cream from an actual ice cream store, local ice cream store, not like Dairy. We did have Dairy Queen though. I was craving Dairy Queen and got Dairy Queen, but there was an actual ice cream shop that I went to. So I'm like, I want to make like an actual list that I can, that is tangible and I can look at, so I can do my seasonal things that I want to do. Who would ever stop building snowman? I know! Those who are, you know, become bitter in life. That's who. Pastry is my only weakness. That dastardly villain placed these cinnamon rolls here. In broad daylight? I'll find you, you scoundrel. I will find you and you will taste my sweet revenge. Or will you taste their revenge? Oh, what's up? The crow's on the... Snowman is so good. Hey, mannequin. You're doing a great job. Thank you. It's my first day. I'm really nervous. Don't be. You're doing great. Thank you. He's having a conversation with the mannequin. I do that all the time. I have conversations with inanimate objects all the time. But it takes more than good looks to succeed in the fashion industry. Really? What else do you need? Willpower. The will to assert yourself in order to achieve your goals and a clear head. Lots of people get taken for a ride on their first job. I got myself a successful agent straight away. And all my management now. Sounds good. Maybe I should try it. Are you sure you got what it takes? I think so. What's the pay like? I have to get back to work now. Stop distracting me. The fashion shows of this world are depending on me. Okay, good luck. I'll keep my fingers crossed for you. When you look as good as me, you don't need luck! Oh my god. Also, we know this crow. They're on our list. I didn't mean to sound like that, but they're on our notes list. I like how he has a notepad of people he's met. I need to do that. It's Kim! Kim, what are you doing? Kim! You look like an NPC that I can talk to. Hi, my name is Chloe Colbert. Look at that. I run Origami, the stationery store. Oh! I've always wanted to do that thing, that challenge, that thing that, like if you folding 1,000 paper cranes in a year. I've always wanted to try doing that. And like, I think the significance is like, I don't know, it's a thing that they do in Japan sometimes. When your silly for fun convo gets out of hand and in depth, oh yeah, very relatable. Do you have a moment to answer a few questions? Sure, what's up? Oh, super. We've noticed that our revenues have been on the decline for some time. So we're conducting a survey of Forcumine's residents to see what we can do. Save small town businesses! Save them! All right, shoot. Which reminds me, I need to go to my locally run yarn store. I need to go do that sometime. I keep going to Michael's. I need to go to the locally owned store. So first question, approximately how many pens do you own? Oh, wow, that's a tough one right off the bat. I have quite a few, but I have my one that I love. And I went to go get more because I'm on the second one of my two pack. And they didn't have any, and I'm upset. I have to look online to see if I can find it. Because I love the feel of this pen, and it's shiny, and it's rose gold. And it's not, and it's inexpensive, so. Hey, Cat, how goes a depressingly realistic animal people adventure? So far, so good. We're going over to the plant shop right now to help out PETA, and then we're gonna have our first night shift, so that'll definitely be interesting, because if y'all have worked at customer service, y'all know the bitterest people are the midnight shift. And I've worked the midnight shift, and I have Tim Hortons, and it sucked, and everyone blames the previous shift for their shift, and you know, so I'm excited to see what's gonna happen. It's definitely giving me, like, even though I never worked in a hospital, it's definitely giving me, so far, flashbacks to my Tim Horton days. That's a tough one right off the bat. I guess that I had to put a number on it. Oh, maybe five? Five pens. Okay. How many times a day do you use a pen? I needed a lot of them when I was at university. These days, I do most things digitally. Even the hospital went digital just before I moved to Porcupine. I see. What about paper? Do you use paper for writing? Not so much. Okay. All right, that's it. Thank you for your time. We'll try to pivot our portfolio to meet the current needs of Porcupine's population. No problem. Happy to help. Girl, I feel so bad for you. Like, I still love stationery. I love journals. I love all the things. Chloe! But, yeah, a lot of things are digital, but I still like going analog, and I wish I could write more on pen and pencil. It's just that all my stuff is digitally organized, and it's more convenient. The pedestrian zone is complete with a salon shop. Hair today, gone tomorrow. Whoa. Oh, for your next demo day, I found out that the Against the Storm demo is still available on Epic. No clue why it isn't on Steam. Interesting. We had a silly full fun combo. A four fun convo with a shopping statue with a mannequin, and it was cute until a statue started a commentary on the fashion industry and got us stressing out about our credentials for our own job. Yeah, that's a great summary. PETA! That just happened. PETA! Girl, I gotta go to work! We've definitely all had days like this. Oh my god. Finbo! Are you okay? Are you hurt? Am I dead? Ha. Ha. Girl. You're the unluckiest person. I know, you know that. I just wanted to come and help. I know, thanks. And you really have to. What do you mean? I needed an idea for my facade. Looks like you sorted that out for me. I'm just glad I brought all the plants in first. What do you mean? It really... What? That look suits you. You just wear it... You should wear it more often. You think? Absolutely. It adds that much-needed touch of color to your face. What do you mean? It's white! White is not a color! It's void of color and it's a shade! No, to be fair, I'm a gray, so I'm all shades. I'm shades of gray, if you will. What if it dries on me? Do you want to come in and wash up? I better had, right? Don't want to stain the beds in the ward later. Oh my god, I would have a mental breakdown if this happened to me. I would get overwhelmed and just break down and cry and then call into work because no. Because no. White is technically all colors at once. Depending on if you're doing additive or subtractive color theory. Right? Are we about to go into color theory? Because if you add all the colors... Because, like, white is void of color when it comes to paint. But in light... But in additive... Or is it subtractive? Is light subtractive color theory? Even with subtractive, all colors at once are being back at you. Right. But, I mean, but like, with paints, right? Like, you add everything together and it's black. And then with light... You add everything and it's white. White is additive, pigment is subtractive. Right. But I'm just saying, white is technically not all colors at once and subtractive is what I meant. So technically, this is void of color because it's pigment, right? I went to art school. It's just been a hot minute since I was there. Let's get to it then. That's my super duper fast dry. What? I would be crying. Pina. That's more like it. Oh, it's still in my feathers. That's more like it. Marvis talk about philosophical theory, methinks. Am I being philosophical? I'm definitely talking about theories. Yeah, I'm talking about, like, you know, because actual pigment, like, paints. But, yeah. My brain. Yeah. You really are a walking disaster, aren't you? You did this to me, Pina! You did this to me! Hold on, I gotta send a good morning text. Good morning! Kissy faces. I'm more of a physics person, so I default to thinking the actual light hitting your eye. Okay, that's fair. But yeah, but no, like, but when it comes to like actual like paints, when you mix all the colors together, they become black. So, or closer to black. As an art person, I guess you default to the pigments involved. Yeah. And then, the light theory, yeah, with the subtractive light, with everything is white. So yeah. So technically, I guess it'd be both then. It is both. When it comes to the light perspective, it is definitely all the colors, but as a pigment thing, it is definitely none of the colors. So we are both right and wrong. Yes, but are pigments actually color, or is the thing that removes... Do you want to have your brains broken a little bit? Yeah, but the light theory is also a theory. It's true. You want to have your brains broken a little bit? Let's talk about this. I like how the combos we have... Depressing Animal Sim and all these combos we have while playing it. I got my brain broken by Hank Green? The one who just is going through remission of cancer. Is that Hank? I think that's Hank. Anyways, I was gonna say the one with the glasses, but they don't have glasses. I watched a TikTok. He's the one that's really prevalent on TikTok. He was talking about color and how all objects aren't the color that they're bouncing back at you. It's because they're rejecting that color. So, like, if you have a red ball, the ball really isn't technically red because it's rejecting the red and bouncing it back at you and it's absorbing the other color. Is that what he said? Is that how he's saying it? Hold on. It's because it's only red when light is being shown on it, and but it's rejecting the red colors and but that's how light theory works. I'm butchering the video. I'm gonna shut up now. But how he said it, it broke my brain a little bit. Because, like, yeah, things only have color in the... I don't know. Shut up. I lost it. I lost the thread. I just hit the microphone. I'm sorry. I'm descending into madness. Cthulhu, I gazed upon you and I can't regain my sanity. Oh yeah, no, for sure. If thing is showing me red, it's red, for sure. But it's just interesting to think about it in a different way. It's just fun to think about, I think. Or how about this? Brown doesn't technically exist because it's just dark orange. And I'm like, no! Anyways, you really are a walking disaster. You did this, Pina! First a box hit you on the head, now a bucket of paint. This is your fault! Maybe it really is just bad luck. You know what I just realized? I haven't even been inside your store before. Nice place you have here. I'm impressed. Thank you. I've put a lot of work into it. How's business going? How do you think? I love my plants. And so does everyone else. I just watered my plants this morning. Are you still looking for an assistant? If you're interested in the position, I'll be expecting a formal application, young man. Hey, it was worth a shot. How's your head? I'm starting to get used to the bumps. Excuse me. Oh my gosh. We'll buy you a helmet with a capital F on it. Oh, Finn. I thought it was going to be F for failure, but it's just Finley. Yeah. That way everyone can see you coming. And ruin my hair? Never. You have hair? I guess those three little feathers sticking up are technically your hair. Never! Have you got time for a day out tomorrow? You know I don't actually want a helmet, right? No, I want to go to the Glow Milk Woods. Want to come with me? Finley, can you hear me? Hello? What? I think I still have pain in my ears. Some careless person dropped a bucket on my head. Oh! The fact that theory has two meanings that are the opposite of each other is one of the most annoying features of the English language. How about flammable and inflammable? That's not annoying at all. And has been the boon to science deniers of all kinds. Oh my gosh. It's just a theory.
A game theory.
Yeah, no, that definitely is. And science deniers are bane. They're bane! Flammable wasn't actually a word in- Ooh, interesting. Some careless person dropped a thing on my head! I'm really sorry. Yeah, she didn't even say apologize to begin with. I would've been like, oh my god, I'm so sorry. It's alright. Yeah, I'm in. Woodland air is good for the health. Great. Okay, time for me. Oh yeah, another thing I didn't do this summer that I wanted to do. I wanted to go to a drive-in theater. Is the drive-in theater still open? I don't know what's out there. I would want to go see everything that we wanted to see. We saw in a proper theater. Drive-in theater. It's fine, I don't need to look it up right now. Okay, time for me to head off to my night shift. See you tomorrow then. I don't even get to go home and shower proper. I still got paint in my face. See you tomorrow then. We'll just meet up at the store again, okay? And watch your head, Finley. Shut up. Though I do love your plants. I love them so. Inflammable was the word, but people kept misunderstanding it from meaning the opposite of what it means. So the word flammable got involved so that stupid people wouldn't set things on fire. Now it's a word. But you have to, inflammable, like, come on, like. This is Penis Car, room for two and 38 plants. Amazing how cluttered it is. Like, you would think that I would have been one of those people. Like, oh, it's inflammable, meaning that you can't. Cause like, unflammable isn't a word, is it? Is unflammable a word? Like infallible, indestructible? I'm totally on the side of the people who are thinking, oh, it's inflammable, meaning that it's not flammable. I'm totally on the... Inflame? I hate English! I hate English so much! What? I thought it was inflamed. It was inflamed? And because, like, engulfed in flames. I hate the English language. The in thing comes from a different root language than inflame. I hate this. I thought it was enflame, like E-N. Enflame. Is it enflame or inflame? Thus, in short, there have been two centuries of confusion and waffling. This must be a British website. Between the two spellings, as roughly as 1600, inflamed has been the more popular form. Many dictionaries and spell checks programs will let you get away with enflame, but inflamed and the I is standard spelling. I hate English! Ah! I hate it! That's what you get when you merge multiple different languages into a single one. I know, and I hate it! This isn't really the place to dive deep into this, but just saying it's not a science denying thing or the two meanings of theory. It's what I recommend is learning about phenomenology. Phenomenology. It's a discipline. It's critical to modern cognitive science. I'm not saying that right. There's a lot of big words! And has a lot of important criticisms about how popular science messes up our view of the world out of scope of what actually applied science tells us. In my opinion, it's a huge reason people ask unrealistic expectation in researchers during the panini. Okay. All the rules I meant. Blame William the Conqueror, I mean. Cognitive science, my bad. No. English existing is his fault. I blame you, William! But that's interesting, because yeah, a lot of people had so many unrealistic expectations. Even not knowing phenomenology. Okay, it's phenomenology. And without even knowing that, I'm like, y'all have unrealistic expectations of these people, because they're like, oh, why is it happening so fast? And vaccine so fast? It's like, do you not know modern science? It's much better than it was before. I think that's what you're trying to go with. I don't know. I assume that's what you were trying to go with that. But yeah, a lot of people just... The common knowledge ain't that common. Common sense ain't that common. Common sense is what I meant to say. Common sense is not that common. But yeah, just people just... Yeah. Yeah. Like, some things are cool to think about, but other things it's just like, come on, be realistic. Like... Ah! But also, yes, William, I hate you. For the existence of English. How dare. True, a lot of skepticisms was based on not understanding how science works. Like, them saying, well, they got it wrong at first. It was a new disease, people! They were all... Right? Right? I'm like, oh my... I feel like a lot of people get it, to be honest, but then some needs to super in-depth explanation. I'd be like, here, just read this, please. Yeah. There are those... And it's always, like, those few that are the most vocal... And it's just like, because like the people that get it, and they don't need to be vocal, and then it's just like, Oh, this is where people suddenly decide it's the best time to go shopping. They keep changing their minds. No, they were still learning and figuring. Exactly! Oh, and then still. And then the people falling for the conspiracies, and I'm like, stop it. 5G didn't cause it, honey. I had to unfollow. I unfollowed some people. Yo, it was our skateboarder with the asthma. Yo, hey, Doc. Larissa, good to see you. How are you doing? Great, I'm feeling good. I'm free again. Very good. And how's your asthma? It's not giving me any problems at all now. I got one of those inhaler things. I even got to choose the color. Really? What did you go for? I ended up getting three. I couldn't make up my mind. Oh, hee. By the way, Doc, love the new look. New look? Oh, nothing. Hee hee hee. Boy, you still got stuff on your face. Feel strange. I really hope Larissa will live. Nice. It's more than that, too. John Gallagher is a good intro. Sorry, for which part of the conversation? We have, like, a few strands of that. The 5G thing was the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. I know. Next to the reptilian conspiracy. Ugh. And the one... That one is still my number one. Yeah, it's just... And I knew somebody before who believed the reptilian thing. And me, being open to, like... I'm too open to so much shit. Like, worse back then. Now I'm more, like, more skeptical. But back then, I'm just like, I was, like, not believing it. But I was open to the idea of, hey, maybe. And then, you know, then Dr. Who did a couple episodes on it. I was like, yeah, nah. There are no reptilians under the earth. Stop it. I was like, school's out for the day. Oh, man, you really start missing your time in school when those days are gone. Well, not the time in school, exactly. I was gonna say... More like time generally. There used to be so much of it. There's just no time! I'm taking the long way back to work. Peanut butter jelly the long way. Oh, I hate that. When the new scene pops up, even though I'm holding going right, it doesn't go right. I have to re-click it to go right. Ugh. No, please. Yeah, the 5G thing, I'm just like, are you freaking joking me? Even if reptilians were a thing, and even if how they could produce hybrids with humans, which is not how reproduction works, the resulting hybrids would not be shapeshifters, exactly, that can switch between human and reptile. Tiglons are shapeshifters, mules aren't shapeshifters. That isn't how it works, right? Right? The world where that actually would work be... Although a world where that is how hybrids... Oh! What the fuck is happening in this hospital? Come and get me if you dare, jelly leg scaredy cat! Oh, you... Stand still! Why are you running... Always running such a... Oh, there's our patients running around! Why are you always such a chicken? Come here! Patients are escaping! Hey, don't running down here. Oh, my old nerves. Were those patients? Were those patients? That would be terrifying. I would not be into the shape-shifting thing. I'd be terrified. Imagine a pit dog that could shapeshift into a direwolf on... No, no, I don't want that. I don't want that. No. No. What's going on here? The Hendersons are what's going on. They brought those two punks in this morning. Emergency, they said. Really? They seem pretty healthy to me. Bored is more like it. That pair can't stay in their beds for more than 1 minute. They're always bickering. Should I go check on them? Up to you. I'm sure you'll get to know them soon enough. In fact, they're both in your ward. Someone probably should check on them, though. Otherwise, we'll need 2 body bags before the day's out. Don't joke about that kind of stuff. But no, shapeshifting? No. Then we wouldn't be allowed to have those dogs because they'd be classified as dangerous. And then people would be like, you know, I just see so many issues happening with that. Oh my god, I'm gonna get in the middle of this and I'm gonna get hurt. That's stupid. You're stupid. You. No, you. Oh, you think you're funny, huh? No, I don't. I think you're stupid. Oh my god, stop it. We're talking fantasy world here? No. Okay, obviously in fantasy world. Okay. Like, there's a... If you brought fantasy elements into the real world, I'd be still iffy on, like, I would... like a fantasy modern our world. But hey, if you throw me into the Lord of the Rings, I'm about it. I'd still be terrified, but I'm about it. But if y'all are bringing in shape-shifting dogs into wolves, no, I don't want to see that. Oh, you're talking about it being an idea for a story setting? Go for it. I'd still be terrified if it was not something I'd actually want to happen. Okay. Now I'm on board. There's a distinction. I know, it's weird. It's like the same, like, I know. But no, I'm on board. Sounds cool. You should write it for NaNoWriMo, which is happening right now. You should do it. Write it. Do it. Have fun with it. Make it happen. Do it. But in real life, no. I would be terrified if I adopted a dog and then all of a sudden it turned into a wolf and I was like, how do I know you won't eat me? Anyways, what's going on here? Rudy stole my dessert. That's not true. You just didn't get any dessert. What can I do about that? Liar, you're mean. You're mean. I didn't do anything. You always say that. They looked right at me. Did you see that? They looked right at me, Marv. Did y'all run back into the hospital? I'm just going this way to check. Okay. Oh, I meant about the expectations of a science. Okay, cool. Like, with Panini, what bothers me is that most of the people who do know it's real but decide to break protocols because of rationale that, yes, on paper makes sense, but hasn't been signed off. But yeah, I'm also trying real hard to avoid going down a rabbit hole while I'm in a fever mode in Twitch chat. Yeah, that's fair. But hey, you will get no arguments here. Because anybody who doesn't believe that the Panini is serious and real should, you know, take a hike. Because it's serious and real. I will fight. Actually, I won't fight. I won't put any energy into you. I'll just, you know, block you. That's why saying that whole combo. Oh! Hello. Panini pandemic. Hence why saying the whole combo I learned from doing applied math or reading Marlowe Ponty. Though that guy is dense as heck as Gallagher. Maybe better intro. Try not to say the word too loosely. Ah, never heard of it. Yeah, I've people called it the Panini. The panorama, if you watch Game Grumps, they called it the Backstreet Boys reunion tour. Yeah, I called it the panorama for a while. Yeah. First night shift, huh? Hehe, because like a lot of things got used to get like also censored or whatnot or flagged if you use the word too. Because, you know, there was a lot of misinformation flying around and things got flagged and stuff. So people avoid saying the words, that way they wouldn't get flagged or anything. Didn't hear the Backstreet Boys one. Yeah, the Game Grumps used the Backstreet Boys reunion tour. And it's not funny, but like Aaron ended up getting getting COVID, and so he's like, yeah, so when they did put out some episodes when he was sick, he's like, or he was in some episodes and wasn't on some, and then it was just like, yeah, Aaron unfortunately got tickets to the Backstreet Boys reunion tour, so we won't be here for this recording session. And it's just like, oh no. I usually heard of it as the illness, but there are a few variations out there. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Unfortunately got tickets to the Backstreet Boys reunion tour. Ah, yes. Everything good with you? Handling the shift okay so far? Yeah, it's weirdly quiet here at this time of night. We call that tiredness. The staff have it, the patients too. Everyone's tired. I love the atmosphere it creates. The stillness really gives the mind space to work. You can think about things that you don't get time to during the day grind. For now, I'll just try to do my duties properly. That's a good idea. Even when Dr. Krakowski is in here, sometimes I can feel her cold breath on the back of my neck. Brr. Hey! Hey, Finley! Mia! You look rushed off your feet. Busy day, huh? Yeah, it's been kind of crazy. The Hendersons in room 302 and keep still for 5 minutes. I can't deal with that kind of thing. Yeah, I just saw those two myself. Really? Where? Downstairs at the main entrance. Oh dear, I just got them back into bed! Anything I need to know? The Hendersons poisoned each other. Oh my god. What? Were they trying to kill each other? No, no. It was a dare, but I'm sure they can explain it better themselves. Oh my god. Are these like, teens, late teens, early 20s, kids, I guess, using the word loosely, y'all are kids. These kids doing like TikTok trends, like, oh yes, the Tide Pod Challenge. Don't do that shit, you'll poison yourself and die. And that's probably what this was them, oh. I dare you to do the Tide Pod Challenge, bro. No, you do the Tide Pod Challenge, bro. And then they record themselves and then this happens. Like, oh my god. I'll look into it right away. It can't be that bad the way they're running around. I don't know. The tests we looked at lunchtime didn't look so great. You definitely won't get bored anyways. And I am going now. Oof. All I want to do is go lay down on the couch. You've earned it. Get some rest. See you tomorrow. Break a leg. These hooligans. Here we go. Tasks downloading. Schedule update. Oop. I got to go see my favorite patient. Oh, my pastor. My favorite patient. Hey, ma'am. Hello, Irma. How are you this evening? Beautiful, isn't it? The fall. It is like, now that October's over and we're in November, I also felt the itch to start doing Christmas shit. But I'm like, you know what? I'm still in my fall era. This is the first year that I fully embraced, like, fall. Like, I've always loved fall. Fall has always been my favorite season. But this is, like, the first year where I'm just like, I'm doing crochet crap that's in deep reds and oranges. I'm doing the things I want to do for autumn. I am living this era. I don't want it to be Christmas yet, because then Christmas, then it, like, jumping into Christmas makes winter feel longer, because winter officially doesn't start till December. And like, I've always felt like, you know, winter lasts forever. I'm like, maybe it's because I jumped too soon into Christmas shit. Wait till December, and then I'll jump into Christmas. My first year that I'm putting off Christmas stuff until December. Usually November, I'm like, I'll start doing stuff at the beginning of November. I'll wait till after November 11th, and then I'll go full blown, you know, putting on the Christmas jams. And no, I'm not a huge fan of the Mariah Carey Christmas song. I think it's okay. And my first introduction to that song wasn't even her version. It was the Cheetah Girls version on their Christmas album. And I am still of the mind that their version is better. Not because I heard it first. Probably because I heard it first. But I still enjoy the Cheetah Girls Christmas version better. But anyways, but the best Christmas album, definitely the NSYNC album. NSYNC's Christmas album, best album. My number one. My number two, Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers! Kenny Rogers, not Keith Urban, you... It was Kenny Rogers, right? Let me look, hold on. Dolly Parton, Kenny... I always, every year, Kenny Rogers, Christmas. Yes, it's Kenny Rogers. Their album, number two. Second favorite album. Third one. Probably Sesame Street. Fourth one, Alvin and the Chipmunks. I could keep going. Fifth one, Kelly Clarkson's got a good Christmas album. Off the top of my dome, those are my top five Christmas albums. But anyways, regardless, I'm pushing Christmas off until December. And then I will, you know, extend Christmassy stuff after December, because it just feels like such an abrupt end when Christmas comes and goes. I'm just like, you know what, I'll taper it off more this year. I'm tailoring my holiday and seasonal enjoyments. I'm tailoring it better this year, in my opinion. It feels better already. Like, I'm still in my fall era, and I'm loving it. And I ran out of cream yarn, and I'm working on this beautiful table runner. And I may not even be able to enjoy all of the autumn stuff that I'm making this season until next year, but you know what? At least I will have it for next year. Because I have this cute gingham... I'll have to share it in the Discord. I made a cute gingham pumpkin that Tobias actually stole off of the shelf and carried into the bedroom yesterday as if it were a toy. Thank goodness he didn't start ripping at it with, and you know, because the stray threads would have sent me. It would have sent me. I made some pumpkin coasters. I made some leaf coasters. I made some cute things here and there, and I'm just like, I'm in my fall era. Feels so abrupt when Christmas just disappears all of a sudden, right? And then everyone's like, okay, tear it down. I'm just like, we had all this buildup. No. So I'm going to be extending Christmas, my Christmassy winteriness into January. Yeah, I'll have to share pictures of the coasters that I made. Some of the coasters I made, like I'm not sure if I shared the Halloween cauldron I made. I made like a cauldron with like bubbly-ness, but when you take it out, they're coasters, and then a couple spider coasters. I like, you know, I figured out how to make them from piecing other patterns together and also like just eyeballing pictures of coasters I've seen people make because they're behind paywalls and I'm like, I really should, you know, pay these people for the but it's not exactly their pattern, so I feel like a little bit like it's not like I'm, you know, sharing the pattern that I made and trying to sell that do it for free. So it's just like I did it for myself, so it's not hurting nobody really, and it's not even their exact patterns anyways. So I like those spider coasters. I don't have $5 right now to give you. I don't have $5 fucking dollars. At the time, I didn't. I have $5 now, maybe. But I want to buy other patterns that I don't know how to do. But I managed to, you know. But anyways, I made spider coasters and cute cauldrons. And I gave that to my mom. And she's like, she calls it her witch's brew. She's so cute. But I did find some free pumpkin patterns for pumpkin coasters. And I made some of those. And I made a leaf coaster, and like little basket, and just a bunch of little crochet leaves and some mini. I have to finish my mini pumpkins. I finally got stuffing. I found pillows. Because like, I didn't want to buy polyfill from Michael's because it's like $30 a box. I bought two pillows, $4 each from the dollar store, and they got polyfill in them. They work just as well. Hack for anybody who, you know, doesn't have a lot of money. Just use the polyfill from fucking pillows from the dollar store, and they work so good. It's also cute. Thank you. I'll show pictures in the Discord later. I'll take pictures of what I made. Currently, I'm in the middle of... I want to make... Sorry, people watching the VOD for the gameplay. I'll get to it in a second. I'm currently working on a long-term project where I want to have an owl for every month. Like an animal for like every month, and I switch it out every month, and it's cute. Like, just a simple thing. And so I decided on owls because I love owls. And I'm currently on the process of a set of three that I'm currently doing in bulk. I did get some eyeballs, though, from the store. And just, like, decorate them differently for each. So I have a lime green one that I'm going to decorate for October and for Halloween and make it look like, you know, Halloween-y. And then I have an autumn one that I'm currently finishing up, like, the base of. And I'm going to use that for, like, either probably a September or a November because it's, like, an autumn red. And And then I have like a summary one that I started for a while ago. And just, you know, just have a cute thing. Cause I saw this one lady on TikTok and she's got like these monthly birds that she switches out in her classroom that she got from Target. And I'm like, I love these birds, but I don't want the birds. I want to, you know, so I decided to make myself owls. And so I'll have like, you know, the owl sitting and switch it out every month. And like, here's my thing that I do every month. But it's gonna take a while, but I'm working on it. So I'll hopefully this time next year I'll have a full set of 12 owls that I can start swapping out every month. Don't know what I'm gonna do for July and August because, you know, there's not a lot happening there. But I have one that's in a summery color. I can use one of those for it. But anyways, I'm back to Irma. Hi, Irma. It's just a pity it always gets dark so early. Oh yeah, because she started talking about fall. This is Irma's fault. This is Irma's fault that we went down this fall tangent. It's Irma's fault. I wouldn't mind a few more hours of sunshine. I feel you, Irma. When are our times going back? Is it tonight? They fall back on Saturday, November 4th, in the wee morning hours of the November 5th. So tonight we get an extra hour of sleep if you are able to do so. Tobias is gonna wake me up at 4! He already wakes me up at like 5. And I don't get up usually till 6:30. He's gonna wake me up at 4! Ah! Gonna wake me up, but I know technically it'd still be the same amount of hours, but mentally I'm gonna see that number 4 and I'm gonna rage. Tobias, I'm getting mad at you, preemptively getting mad at my cat for waking me up early tomorrow. I'm so mad. Anyways, I wouldn't mind a few more hours of sunshine. It's bright enough in here though, luckily. True, but a long walk in the fall air would do me some good. Still, you're right. You know, when I was young, light wasn't a given. We always had to catch it first. Catch it? The light. It used to be more agile than we're used to today. It was quite tricksy. I'll tell you the story if you like. I have work to do. But you know what? Alright, but only if I'm not keeping you from your work. It's okay. Think of it as part of my job. That's true. I am your patient after all. Hee hee. Krakowski? Krakowski? Gonna get mad at me. But I don't give a hoot. But I'm not a... Yeah, I can't give a hoot because I'm not an owl. I'm a pigeon. That's true. I am your patient after all. Hee hee. All right, let's see now. Oh, we're getting a cutscene. You know, I think this is a perfect place to call a break. Because I need one and I need to stretch my back out because it's starting to hurt. Because I'm sitting with poor posture. I'm sitting with such poor posture. We're going to take a break. Because we're halfway through the stream time. But yeah, y'all. Stretch. Grab a snack. Grab a drink. Cutscenes in this economy? I know, we're being spoiled. Grab a snack. Grab a drink. Stretch. Take your meds if you got them. And I'll be back in about 10-15 minutes. Where's my thing? BRB!